One of the newest features in QuickBooks Online is the ability to set different price structures for different types of clients. It's called price rules. It's actually still in beta. But what it allows you to do is have a dropdown every time you sell a product so that if you have different prices for retail customers versus wholesale customers versus manufacturers versus, hey, your friends and family, you can easily pick the different prices from the list. You can even assign that default price to your different customers. Let's take a look at how it works. The first thing that we need to do is set it up. To do that, we're going to go up to Account and Settings, which is up under the gear in the upper right-hand corner, and then Account and Settings. Then we're going to go to the Sales area on the left-hand side right here. And here under Products and Services is Turn on Price Rules. You'll notice that it is in beta. It's not an official feature, but it's been there for almost a year. So at some point, they'll take that little beta off of it. So we have price rules turned on. So we'll say done. Now we need to create our price rules. So I'm going to go up to the gear, and then I'm going to go to All Lists. And under All Lists, down on the left-hand side, you see price rules. This has already been set up a little bit so that you can see the what's your options are. So price rules are really powerful and allow you to do all kinds of flexible things with your pricing. You can set different pricing by customer type. You can set different pricing for different products. You can also do sales. For instance, we see that there's a customer sale in here. Let's take a look at how this works. Let's start by making our wholesale pricing. So I'm going to go into this wholesale and we're going to edit it and see how it came to be. The first thing that you do when you're creating a price rule is to name it. So these are my wholesale prices. If you wanted to make it date sensitive, like that sale that I was mentioning earlier, you can give it a start date and an end date. And then after that end date, the prices go back to normal. You have the ability to have it apply to all of your customers or only specific customers. So in this case, I would want my wholesale pricing only available to my wholesale customers. So I don't want it to say all customers. I want it to be selected individually. And there's a tab right here that says customers, and I can see the people who have been given that price structure. Now, in this case, Allison Ball and Emmett Burkowski are not actually wholesale. So if I have someone on the list that I don't want, I can click the trash can and take them off of the list. If I have somebody that I want to add to the list, I simply click Add Customer, and it will bring my customer dropdown, and I can go in and find the customer who gets the wholesale prices. So we'll give those to Quality Built Construction, which is my contractor. Oh, they're already on it. Okay, I will do it to Dan Tefford. And so now they have been added to that list. Once you've decided which customers it applies to, we can also specify whether it's all of our products and services, or we can select them individually, or we can assign it to just products and services. We can assign it to just services, just inventory products, just non-inventory products, or to products that fall in different categories if you're using categories with your products. So you can do an entire category, you can do it to certain types of products, or just to individual products. I'm going to click select individually so that you can see how this works. And I'll click add product or service. And the example that we've been working with in this lesson today are my cabinets and vanities. And again, not that we have it split up into our installation services and the actual physical cabinets themselves. I just want to wholesale the cabinets themselves. Here is the price that I normally sell it for. Here's my cost. This gives me the ability to apply the discount right here. Now, check this out. I don't have to type in the discounted price. I do have tools up at the top that will allow me to set the prices for many all at one time. Let's actually add more products and services to this list so that we can see it happen all at once. I'm going to go down to my product sold category, and there's a couple in there, so I've added another one to that. Maybe I will also add it to, let's see, do I have any other inventory? We'll go ahead and we'll add it to all of our inventory products as well. Now, my resolution has gotten a little scrunchy, so I can hold my cursor between the column headers to see what they are. For some reason, my SKU wants to be huge, even though I'm not using it. So let's readjust my category, my sizes a little bit. Now that I've selected all of the products that I want to apply it to, I have the option of changing it by a percentage or a fixed amount, or have the ability to set each price individually custom. Let's say, since these are wholesale customers, I only want to charge them 60% of the retail price. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose percentage, and I have the choice of increasing and decreasing. I'm going to decrease it by 40%. So I'm going to have the sales price 40% lower than the normal sales price. So again, these are wholesale customers. Now, I have to be careful here that the price that I'm selling it for is not less than my cost on the goods. So even though that made sense, that might not be an adjusted price. You always a good price. Maybe I only want to decrease my retail by 20%. So now it will adjust the price again. Actually, it doesn't look like it's quite working, is it? Oh, I know what I didn't do. I didn't click the apply button. There we go. So now I clicked apply. And when I go ahead and look at this, so now I'm still over my cost. I'm not losing any money. And my adjusted prices are a little better than they were. I have the ability also to set rounding if I would like to round it up to the nearest 0.05 or any of these increments, or maybe your sales prices always end in a 49 so that you can tell that those are your sales prices. You can do that rounding and then apply it. That's what a lot of retail stores, especially the big box stores, do so that they can tell which ones are their sale prices and which ones are their regular prices. So we've added a 49. Rounding to the end of each one. So that's how to set the different price rules. So I've got that applied, and I will save and close it down here at the bottom. So the Christmas sale was done somewhat the same way. Let's go take a look and see what was different about that one. In this case, it's done only for a date range. It's only from the 15th to the 24th, which is what makes it a Christmas sale. It does apply to all of the customers, and it's applying to all of the products in just one category, our supplements category, and we're giving them a 25% discount with an 88 cent rounding. And so now we have sale prices. And so again, this is nice because these price adjustments will only be available during that time frame. They're not going to show up at any other time. When I want to use them with these price rules with my clients, one thing that I can do is set default price rules. If I go to sales and then customers, I can define a customer as a certain type of customer. If I go into quality built construction, for example, and I go into the edit button in the upper right hand corner, if I look in additional info right here, I can set them to a default customer type. And if I make this wholesale, hopefully this is actually going to work. It looks like they haven't, this is why it's in beta, and it doesn't look like it's fully working yet, but the idea is that we can set that customer type to wholesale, and they will always get the wholesale pricing. I'm going to go ahead and cancel it since we didn't make any changes. Now that I have worked with the different tools, when I make an invoice for a particular customer, so I'm going to go up to the plus sign and make an invoice. I can see that when I put in the client name up at the top and I pick a particular product or service, I'll go ahead with those dinosaur kale supplements that we had earlier. Notice that the rate field has a drop-down in it, which will show me the wholesale rate because I assigned this customer the wholesale rate. It's the first one on the list. And so if I did want to go back to the regular price, I could, or there is their wholesale price. So that's how it shows up when you are having your customers pay for the services. As you can see, the price rules have a lot of flexibility, and therefore it's a great way of not having to remember who gets what price.